roots or x-intercepts or the zeros of a cubic function are 3, though there are instances where you can have 2 or you can have 1. But today we want to look at all the 3 x-intercepts or all the 3 roots or the 3 zeros of the cubic function. So under this case, we are going to use the method called synthetic division. Mind you, there is a method called k-method, long division method, and other series of methods that can be used. But in my case, I believe that using the synthetic division method is a simplified way, the simple way of showing you how to work out this. So the first thing we're going to do is to use what we call the try and error method. So the try and error method says that just take any value, because we are looking for x values. So take any value of x. Where there is x, you substitute that value for x. And then on your calculator, you can press equal to and see if this is equal to 0. Because the x-intercept of a function is the root of the function, which when you substitute in place of x into the equation, the whole equation becomes 0. So let us try. Usually you try with negative 1. So when we substitute negative 1 for x, you see where there is x, we substitute the value of negative 1. On your calculator, if you press equal to, what do you get? 40. Yeah. So it means that the value here is not a root of the function. It's not an x-intercept of the function. It is not a zero of the function. So what we have to do is to change negative 1 to positive 1. And also see what the answer is going to be like.
Zero.
So if the answer is 0, then the value which is 1 here is the root of the function. So in this case, our first root will be x is equal to this number 1. And we can say our first factor will be x minus 1. So this becomes our first factor and our first root. So just after getting the first root, the next thing you have to do is to draw a line. And this line is going to be used for the synthetic division method. This is the beginning of the synthetic division method. Now, we have 1, 2, 3, 4 terms. Therefore, on this line, we are going to have all the 4 terms that are written there. The first term is positive 2, the next one is negative 4, the next one negative 22, and positive 24. Whatever you write here is called the first root. This is the value. So I'll write 1 here. Now, whatever first term you have here, you must repeat it. So I have plus 2. Now, this times this, all the numbers that come up here must multiply the root on this side. So this times this will give us plus 2. Now plus 2 minus 4 will give us minus 2, right? This times this will give us minus 2. This plus this will give us minus 24. This times this will give us minus 24. So therefore this plus this will give us 0. Always remember, when synthesizing or simplifying or breaking down or simplifying a cubic function using the synthetic division, what will come out will no longer have 4 terms, but will have 3 terms. Are you following me?
Yeah.
Now, if you have 3 terms, it means we have something like ax squared plus bx plus c, which is equal to 0. So out of the cubic function now, we are synthesizing to get a quadratic function. So therefore, our first value will be 2x squared minus 2x minus 24 is equal to 0. So now, when we get there, what is going to happen is to solve